much he out there, I was shocked how much he out there.
Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazadaq. I'm coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shah. We begin all things with the name. And once again, for the record, I would like to reserve all of my rights according to the Constitution and the Bill of Rights of the Federal Republic. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney and please be advised. If you decide to use any of this information and not research it, it is your own fault if you fall on your face, because you should research everything and trust no one. With that being said, I wanted to talk to you about the promissory note, because I think that many of us do not clearly understand exactly what the promissory note, those green bills, or those, whatever you want to refer to them as, the dead presidents that you have in your pocket, or your billfold, or your purse. Now, the promissory note was actually given by government to pay our debts once we was deprived of the gold. Remember our House Joint Resolution, I've speaking of this before, House Joint Resolution 192 on June 5th, 1933, the promissory note, which was the promise of Abraham, the great emancipator. Huh, that's trivial. The government issued it to actually balance the exchange, to actually credit we, the people. Now, the promissory note is the debt side of the United States government ledger, to those of you that don't understand that, which was actually debited from their credit created by executive order on April 5th, 1933, when they actually took the gold out of circulation, because the government went bankrupt, not we, the people. Make no mistake about that. Now, they're actually compelling the people to pay for their mistake, fulfilling the scriptures again. So, public policy, basically, is actually rooted in House Joint Resolution 192. And actually, through grace, it actually creates our exemption. So, this promissory note is your temporary savings grace, because you can't, you understand that this promissory note, you understand what this means? It's a promise to pay. It's a promise to pay. So, how can I actually pay a debt by giving someone else another debt? You can't cancel out a debt with a debt. And that's what many of you are not understanding. This is why those of us that understand or comprehend says that there is no money. Because you can't cancel out a debt with a debt. But you'll kill each other over paper that they print that almost has no value. It's not backed by gold. It's not backed by silver anymore. So, I mean, it's a promise to pay. Yeah, you'll go out and you kill your brothers over this. The government could take the value off of it tomorrow, and it'll be worthless. You could use it to start a campfire. They place a value on it. But in reality, it has no substance that's worth anything. So this is your temporary savings grace. But the true grace comes from the Creator. Make no mistake about that. So under grace, the law falls away. Under grace, their law, but we know what the true law is. So this public policy actually removed the people's liability to make all payments by actually making a contract, and it actually makes the contract null, void. It's a payment by making a contract null, and if actually required, the payment to be in substance, because the people actually didn't have any money to pay with. Now, all that must be done now is to discharge the liability, if you could understand what I'm saying, and pay now So we discharge the liability and we pay and pay and discharge are basically similar words. When you look at the principles of what they actually represent, they are similar, but the principles are as different than the Torah and the New Testament. Now, when we look at the word pay, it is equated with gold, silver, or something of substance, not a promissory note. Like a firstborn lamb, it has substance, it represented something, which actually requires tangible work to actually be invested into it, to actually remove the liability, because some sort of execution must occur. Now the word discharge is actually equated with paper. I'm going to say that again. The word discharge is actually equated with paper. Or to make it more simplistic or basic, simple like credit and debts that actually exist on paper only. Like the state held by the agents and so on and so forth. If you can understand what I'm saying here. So the word discharge is actually equated with paper. Now you cannot pay a bill with a bill. You can't do that, brothers and sisters. You cannot pay a bill with a bill. You cannot pay a debt with a debt. So with House Joint Resolution 192 or HJR 192 did was actually remove the liability of any obligor, actually meaning, you know, someone obligated to pay a debt. That's what House, in real truth, that's what House Joint Resolution 192 did. It actually removed the obligation to actually pay a debt by making it against public policy to pay debts. Now, all that actually needs to be done now is to discharge the debt with the appropriate credit, dollar for dollar. So many of you try to do an A for V, and you're not getting positive results because you don't understand what you're doing. Now, the brothers and sisters, the debt must be discharged for dollar in the same sense. As sin was actually discharged by Yahusha or Yeshua on the cross. We was actually saved because Yahusha was crucified for us, hopeless sinners. So the moment that a debt, and all of this is spiritual, and this is what many of you are not understanding. All of this is spiritual. It's all spiritual. Many of you are operating on a physical plane. So many of you do not understand my words, because you're not walking in the spirit. I'm not of this world. You probably think I'm crazy for that statement, but that's what they thought of Yeshua, Yahusha, or Christ. So now the catch is this. If we can't write off debts because we are actually not in the possession of the account deficit, so our fiduciary agent is actually in possession of that account. So we can actually discharge the liability through their Internal Revenue Service. And when I say that, I mean their bookkeeper. So most of us feel that when the money was taken out of society, the people became slaves. Now, you might hear me refer to you as slaves because I'm referring to that mental state. Because many of you are stuck in that mental state that you can't. That you can't seem to get out of. I'm going to continue this in the next video, because I'm running out of time here. Shalom. Shalom. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazadaq, and I'm going to continue on. Once again, for the record, I would like to reserve all of my rights according to the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of the Federal Republic. This is not legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney, and please be advised. If you decide to use any of this information and fall flat on your face, it's your own fault because you did not research it. research everything and take nothing for face value. That is a responsibility that solely falls upon you. So, as I was speaking of in the first part of the video, that most of us feel that when the money was taken out of society, that people became slaves. And you are slaves of a mental death and power. That's actually what enslaves you. But, I mean, in a physical sense, it's not necessarily true unless you're actually in the prison system, in their jails. The people was actually freed from the obligation that society actually could create. And this actually freed the people from that obligation. Now, you have to ask yourself the question when you get a bill or what have you. What are you charging me with? And how do you expect me to pay? And this is what I try to subtly suggest to those of you that say my accepted for value is not working. What the heck do you mean it's not working? How are you going to pay the debt? How are you going to discharge the debt with a debt? So you got to ask yourself the question and them, what are you charging me with? And how do you expect me to pay? I mean, in realistic terms, being realistic. Because to be very simplistic, there is no money, brothers and sisters. I'm going to make it plain. I'm going to make it plain for you. Simple and plain, there is no money to make the payments. So, I mean, how to do it? They expect you to pay. How do you expect me to pay the payment with a debt on top of a debt? So if I was to pay it, who's paying me? Who's paying me? Who's paying the guy? Who's paying the guy? Who's paying the guy? You understand what I'm saying? This promissory note is a debt. It is a promise to pay. And there's no designated time that's actually specified when you are to be paid. It's just a promise to pay. So the guy... On the guy who's paying him. Brothers and sisters, this is public policy. This is not law. This is actually the supersedious bond, because it actually limits we, the people, our liability to pay. Now, I mean, we can't pay it. We can't pay it. There is no real money. So, this is why I encourage you to be aware of contracts. So, as we go on through this process of coming into a mental state of awareness and realizing the position that our government has placed us in, we go as far as we can to fulfill our obligations with an acceptance and tax return. And after we have done all that we could do, mercy comes in. That's what Yeshua's coming was about. It was for mercy. It was for mercy. Mercy comes in. Grace kicks in. So the A for V is a form of mercy and grace. For those of you that don't understand, many of you don't understand this because it's spiritual. And you're carnal. Many of you are carnal as heck. So you'll never get this. You're not, what am I, this is not work. Yo, this is mercy, man. Like, for example, during the Torah, in the Old Testament, homosexuals was outright murdered. They was put to death, according to the book of Leviticus. It says they was put to death. If a man sleep with a man, the blood should be upon them. They should surely be put to death. If you went out on me and you committed adultery, you was put to death. But with the coming of Yahawasha, that's when mercy comes in. He said you could repent. You know, I died for your sins. So that's mercy. So the A for V is mercy, but you don't understand it because you're carnal as hell. You're carnal as hell. You can't walk in the spirit if you continue to walk on a physical plane. So many of you don't understand me. You say, oh, Tazadaq, he's going off. It's because you don't understand me. You're of the world. I'm not of this world. Yeshua said it. Yahweh said it. You're not of this world when you're walking in.